Hi, myself Rajarashmi Srey from Vidyarashmi First Aid College Savanur. Now I am taking business taxation of secondary BCom. Under that we are already studied about the incidence of tax. Now we can see the problems which appeared in the year 2011. 2011 problem we can solve now. So the transaction is given like this. First one is business income in Bangalore. So business is in Bangalore, controlled from London, 25% received in UK, rupees 5 lakh. We already know it. If the business is due, is the income is due in India, deemed in India, received in India, three columns, yes, yes, yes. So no need of seeing next one, that is controlled from India. Leave it. It is enough. Business in Bangalore. So we can write in three columns, 5 lakh, 5 lakh, 5 lakh. Next one is business income from Sri Lanka controlled from Bangalore. So business in Sri Lanka, but it is controlled in Bangalore. So see here, business in Sri Lanka means foreign income, but it is controlled from Bangalore. Controlled and set up means in India means two column, yes, yes. So give importance to this one. Relating to India, it is controlled in India. That means two columns, yes, yes. Amount is given 1,80,000. So write 1,80,000 in two columns because it is controlled in India. Next one is salary received in India. Salary is received in India. That means salary is due in India. Within bracket it is given, excluding rupees 40,000. From service rendered in Dubai, in bracket closed, written rupees 2 lakh. So, no need of seeing the bracket. It is enough. Salary which is received in India. So, any income received in India means yes, yes, yes. So, income, salary due in India, adre saaku namge. Moru column, yes. Athava received in India antadre saaku. Adu moru column, yes. Matte nodbeku anta illa. So, if his amount is 2 lakh. So you write three columns, 2 lakh, 2 lakh, 2 lakh. Next one is agriculture income from land situated in Pakistan. Within bracket 25% is remitted to India. Once again, remitted to India, brought to India, leave it. It does not affect the tax. Only we have to take it consideration, agriculture income in Pakistan. So agriculture income in foreign country means first column yes, next two columns dash dash. Amount is 90,000. So write in first column 90,000 and next two columns dash dash. That means it is taxable in the hand of OR, that is ordinarily resident. Next one is interest on deposit with company in India. Within bracket given, rupees 40,000 received in France. So leave the bracket. It is enough, interest from Indian company. So interest in India. So two columns, yes, yes, sorry, three columns, yes, yes, yes. Amount is 80,000. So we have to write in three columns, 80,000, 80,000 and 80,000. Next transaction is profit on sale of building in Bangalore received in London. So it is enough, profit is due in, profit on sale of building in Bangalore. It is enough. Then no need of seeing the other thing, that is received in London. Receive early sadly, but income is due in India. So three columns, yes, yes, yes. So we have to write three columns the amount, that is 1,20,000, 1,20,000 and 1,20,000. Easy. Yavadadru profit athava income bandu India bandre, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹ ಮೂರು ಕಾಲಮ್ ಎಸ್ 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 ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆದ್ರೆ, ಡ್ಯೂ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆದ್ರೆ ಸಹ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬೇರೆ ಏನು ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಿಲ್ಲ. ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಡೀಮ್ಡ್ ಅರೈಸನ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಬೇರೆ ನೀವು ಓದುವ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆನೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವಾಗ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಮೂರು ಕಾಲಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಂತ ಆದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅಗತ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಓದುವಂತದ್ದು. ಫುಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಮುಗೀತು. ಎಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಔಟ್ಸೈಡ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್, but it is dividend from foreign company means foreign income. We have to write the amount in the first column. That means it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. So the amount is 44,000. So in the first column you have to write 44,000. Next two columns dash dash because it is a foreign income. Next one is interest on deposit with Pakistan branch of SBI. So it is enough. It is the branch of SBI means it is nothing but Indian bank. Branch yavadadre irutte bank India adre three columns yes yes yes. So 60,000. So we have to write in three columns 60,000, 60,000 and 60,000. Next transaction is interest on deposit with Bangalore branch of HSBL bank. No need of any bank, anything. So the deposit in Bangalore means enough. Bangalore branch means enough. It is Indian bank. So three columns yes, yes, yes. So we have to write in three columns the amount. So interest in Bangalore. Amount is 20,000. So we have to write the amount in three columns 20,000, 20,000 and 20,000. Next one is income from house business property in Bangalore received in Pakistan. So it is enough. Income from house property in Bangalore. Tumba easy and ondhe irudu tax alli incidence of tax. Adu kali kelo terms nenepittre saaku. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಏನು ನೋಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಣ್ಣು ಮುಚ್ಚಿ ಫ್ರೀ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂತಿಲ್ಲ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ ಡೆಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಸರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್ ಸೆಟಪ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಷ್ಟು ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನು ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎನಿ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಸೊ ಹೌಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ So the amount is 50,000, 50,000 and 50,000. Next one is gift from a friend received outside India 4 lakh. So gift from a friend rupees 4 lakh. So it exceeds 50,000 once again, and it is received outside India. That means foreign country. So one first column is yes, it exceeds 50,000. So first column yes, then last next two columns dash dash. If it is received in India means three columns yes yes yes. Next, gift from a friend received in India. See next one, gift from a friend received in India on the occasion of marriage. So if the gift exceeds 50,000 from a friend, then full amount is taxable. So full 70,000 is taxable because it is in India. So three columns yes yes yes. If any gift received from the relatives, fully tax free. Next one is gift in euro currency from a relative received in India. So any gift which is received from the relatives means it is fully tax free. So dash dash dash. If you want to escape the tax, you just show that this particular income or particular cash or particular thing is gifted by your relative, then full amount is tax free. Tax and avoid madalu idu ond method. Hechagi enta martara property nella gift aagi kodtare age enagtare gift aagi kotre kudle alli avarge tax anta agudilla. Gold gift kotre tax illa. Next property hechagi enadu gift anta kotre yavudu tax agudilla. ನಿಜವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಿಕೊಡಬಾರ್ದು, ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ನಾವೇ ರಾಂಗ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಈ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಎಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿಕೊಂಡು ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಎಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಎಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್. ಸೊ ಎನಿ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಎಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಈಸ್ ಫುಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್. ಸೊ ಓವರ್ ದೆನ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್. First column we get 18,14,000. First column 18,14,000. Second column is 12,15,000. 80,000, 12,80,000, and the last column is 11 lakh. So this problem is over. We can see that in the next class. Thank you.